Welcome to the second video in the Scriabin Theory series. In this video, we'll discuss how Scriabin uses musical climaxes by going through several examples in his work. First, let's talk about what a musical climax is and what it might have meant for Scriabin. The term climax refers to sections of peak intensity in music and other forms of art. Although deciding whether a section is a climax or not is admittedly vague and open to interpretation, I've made a definition for a musical climax for the purpose of this video. A musical climax is a section of music with sustained loud intensity which is arrived at by a buildup of momentum. Let's listen to an early example from one of Scriabin's short preludes. In that example, we heard a build-up section that gains momentum before a sudden burst of energy, which is the climax section. Now let's consider why Scriabin uses climaxes so often in his works. Scriabin said, "As a person in the moment of a sexual act, in the moment of ecstasy, loses consciousness and all of his organism in all its points experience bliss, thus God-man, experiencing ecstasy, will be filled with universal bliss and burn up in fire." To me, this suggests that Scriabin uses climaxes in his music not only to represent sexual climaxes, but at the same time to represent spiritual transformations. He hopes to overwhelm the listener with ecstatic music to shift their regular state of consciousness to one of universal bliss. However you interpret his use of climaxes, we can probably agree that deliberate culmination to peak musical intensity is an effective tool to creating aesthetically pleasing music. Let's explore how Scriabin implements climaxes throughout his larger works. In Sonatas 3 and 4, Scriabin introduces the primary motif in one movement very softly, begins the sonata form in the next movement, and brings the primary motif to a climax by the very end in the coda. Let's listen to Sonata 4's primary motif in Movement 1 before we listen to the same primary motif brought to a climax at the end of Movement 2. Now let's listen to that same theme brought to a climax in the final movement. Sonata 5 and the Poem of Ecstasy raise the bar by including two climaxes, one at the end of the development section and another in the coda. The primary motif in Sonata 5 is originally marked languid, but when it's used as a climax in the coda, it's marked ecstatic. This demonstrates how Scriabin uses climaxes to elevate themes that were previously quiet and low in energy. In Sonata 5, this relates to the narrative about bringing audacity to timid shadows of life. Sonatas 6 and 8 don't really have climaxes. Instead, they have abrupt bursts of energy, and they end with Scriabin's reoccurring dance motif. This dance motif has 2 beats per measure, and its intense speed can be used as a substitute for a climax. Sonata 7 begins with peak intensity of the primary motif. With so much intensity throughout the sonata, Scriabin has to introduce a new soft theme in the development section to create an even more intense climax section by the end. Part of why Scriabin fans love this sonata so much is because of how over-the-top this final climax is. Sonatas 9 and 10 go back to only having one climax. Sonata 9 culminates in a terrifying climax in the coda, and Sonata 10 brings Theme 2 to a climax in the development section, using the dance motif in the coda. Prometheus, the Poem of Fire, features his most advanced use of climaxes. There are about 4 climaxes spread out through the work, each one longer than the last. Like previous pieces discussed earlier, the largest climax at the very end is the primary motif. Overall, Scriabin's musical climaxes began from taking a low-energy primary motif and transforming it to a climax by the end. He later would include climaxes in both the coda and the development section. He was always trying techniques to top his previous work, and by the end created Prometheus, the Poem of Fire, with multiple recurring climaxes spread out throughout the piece. His use of musical climaxes may have been inspired by his philosophy of spiritual transformation and relate to the narratives of each work. I don't have time to get into how each climax section affects the narrative in each piece, but you can explore Scriabin's use of musical climaxes on my YouTube channel, which shows his scores with highlighted themes. What's your favorite musical climax in Scriabin's work? Let me know in the comment section. Like, subscribe, and support me on Patreon.